In this video, we'll look at using the P3 payload combined with the GS120 for non-stop wind turbine inspection. We have to use the GS120 as this allows us to have high enough shutter speeds to freeze the blades in motion. There are a lot of conditions on getting good results here, including lots of daylight, a high enough shutter speed, and using the correct settings on the payload. For this demo, we'll show you on a small indoor turbine, but some real-life images collected in the field. There are two different ways to trigger the camera for non-stop wind turbine inspection. The first we have is laser triggering, and this will allow a capture to take place every time the laser rangefinder is broken. We will set a far and close distance in the controller, which will indicate where the wind turbine will cross. When the laser rangefinder detects something moving within this range, it will trigger an image. We can set this up inside the DJI controller by going to Menu, Auto Capture Mode, and Laser. We can then select the AF Max and AF Min distance. As we're inside here, I know the wind turbine is between our minimum focus distance and 4.5 meters. We can see as the wind turbine rotates, it breaks the LRF, which will help us trigger this image. We can also select how many captures we want to take per trigger. Here I've selected 3, as we are working with a wind turbine with 3 blades. I can then push the capture button, and it will trigger 3 times when the laser rangefinder is broken. As there is a small delay between the laser rangefinder being broken and the image being taken, you may wish to use time triggering for a more accurate result. The timed laser auto capture mode will first of all time the passes of the wind turbine blades and then predict the next passing, giving a more accurate result. First of all, it will measure when the laser rangefinder is broken, and then it will use this to predict the next time the blades will pass in front of the camera. This is great for capturing a leading edge of the wind turbine. Once again, we can set this up in the menu by going to Auto Capture Mode and Timed Laser. Once again, we would select our AF Min and Max distance and the amount of captures we wish to make. This time you can see when I push the capture trigger, it times the first rotation and then triggers 3 times in a row. If we are still not getting the desired blade position within our image, we can go to laser triggered capture correction and adjust this plus or minus in milliseconds to give us a better result. By doing this, we can make sure our wind turbine blade is in the desired position. Here we have a few sample images from the real world. Results may vary depending on the speed of the wind turbine blade, lighting conditions, and camera conditions. It may be necessary to put the camera in manual focus to get the best focus results on the wind turbine blade. If you need help calculating your pixel blur on a moving wind turbine, you can download the Non-Stop Wind Turbine Pixel Blur Calculator from our website. The link will be in the description for this video.